Yeah, I'm an atheist, man. I'm an atheist. Yeah, I'm not an agnostic. You know, agnostic people, they're not sure if God exists. They're not sure if God doesn't exist. So they just sit on the fence. They sit in the middle, which is fine. Yeah, if you don't know, that's cool on it. But yeah, I'm an atheist. Yeah, I agree with certain things in the Bible. Yeah, I agree with certain things in the Bible. Obviously, thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not steal. Those are the only two 10 commandments I know. And obviously the proverbs and that, you know, the teachings, like they might say something mad, like, I don't know, caught me if I'm wrong. Was it Delilah, or there was a female in the Bible, and basically whoever wrote the Bible basically said that, you know, women are very manipulative and stuff like that. Yeah, you can't trust them or for whatever in it, man. I believe in, like, you know, the teachings like that. I believe in teachings like that. Obviously some of the proverbs, as I said before, like, I'm not saying this is one out of the Bible, but you know, if there's no enemy within, then the enemy outside can't do us no harm. I actually went to church. Nah, fam, I'm not agnostic. No, I'm an atheist. I know, yeah, there's no God. I truly believe. I don't believe that God can exist because I don't believe in the supernatural. I don't believe in spirits. I don't believe in ghosts. I don't believe in fairies or Santa Claus or flying unicorns or the Loch Ness Monster or the Sasquatch or Bigfoot or the Minotaur. I don't believe in any supernatural. I'm 27 years old. I've never seen a fucking ghost before, innit? Now, I know there's gonna be some people come in the comment box below or the comment section and say, oh, I've seen a ghost. Yeah, whatever, man. He was tripping. Yeah. I think the main reason why a lot of people believe in God, yeah. The most profound question, yeah. The most intense question. What happens when we die? I think that's the main reason why anyone subscribes to any religion, yeah? Any holy book, could be the Torah, could be the Bible, could be the Quran, yeah. Any holy book they subscribe to, any religion, is simply because they basically want to know what happens in the afterlife, right? The most profound question in the world is what happens when you die? And for me, if someone asks me the question, what happens when you die? Nothing. I know it's hard to take it, yeah? But even like, I think to myself, like, how can there be nothing when you die? Because, like, I'm an atheist and stuff. I believe in science and that, and I believe there's no afterlife in it. But even I have to think to myself, like, I'm conscious, yeah? I'm conscious, yeah? I know what I'm doing right now. I'm talking to this fucking camera like a madman, yeah? Whatever. I'm aware of my surroundings, yeah? I'm conscious, but what happens to that consciousness when you die? Like, even I find that difficult. Like, what happens? Does it just go black? Like, does it go black like that? Like, what happens? Huh? What happens to our consciousness when we die? Like, does it just go all black? That's for me, that's a difficult question to answer, innit? But I know the answer is not we float up into the sky and yeah, and there's 10 virgins or whatever. Yeah. So I think a lot of people believe in God simply because they don't know what happens when they die, or they need to have some kind of hope that, you know, there's something after death. Now, I don't think I know there's nothing after death, unfortunately. Yeah. Unfortunately, we're not reincarnated into dogs or cats or whatever, innit? or you know, we don't get reincarnated into once you're dead, done. I know it's hard to fathom. I find it hard to fathom. How can it just be nothing? How can I just not exist no more and that's it? But unfortunately, you can't ask anyone who's experienced it because they're dead. So they can't communicate with us to tell us, oh, this is what happened. Now, there's people, right, who they've died on the operating table and been revived. And then they say, oh, I had this sensation of me floating in the air and I can see my body. And they described all of the instruments that the doctors and the surgeons used to bring them back to life, whatever. And I'm, I don't know. Yeah, I don't know, man. But I know there's no afterlife. I don't believe that there's a heaven or a hell. I think this whole thing, like the whole religion thing, I know you believe in fairies, Nadia. This whole religion thing has just been invented to control people, to keep people in line. If you are a good person, you go to heaven. If you are a bad person, you go to hell. So be a good person. Do what we say. Follow the Ten Commandments. Don't step out of line or you will be punished. You will go to hell if you step out of line. That's trying to control people. Don't get it twisted, though. The Ten Commandments, I'm assuming all 10 of them are really, yeah, positive or whatever, innit? I don't know. I ain't read the Ten Commandments or whatever, innit? Yeah, but I'm assuming, you know, if you follow the Ten Commandments, you will be a good person. Right, so obviously then Clark Cole, Creative Media Innovators, and obviously, yeah. So if you don't know if God exists or not, then yeah, you'll be an agnostic, definitely. Which is fine. If you don't know, you don't know. That's cool, isn't it? I'm on this Facebook group called The Atheists, and I can't really remember the posts as such when I first joined the group, because I got an invitation from a friend to join this Facebook group called the Atheist Group. But I'm assuming when I first joined, if it was like a year ago, it was more sensible or whatever. And people used to talk about science and stuff like that, or they will talk about, oh, you know, this person was pressured into religion, or they left the religion and they were murdered by their parents, whatever. But now it's just turned into some kind of fool, like, not all the posts, but now and then you just get some idiots on there, like, look, it's fun to make little jokes about religion and stuff, isn't it? Yeah, but some of these people take it too far. I'm like, bro, like, me, I'm a respectful atheist, you know, like, I don't disrespect people's religion or faith or nothing like that. I would never go and, you know, go into church and disrespect anyone or anything like that. Like, I'm a respectful atheist, but these people in this atheist group, man, some of them are just like little devils, man, little trolls, man. You want to see some of the bullshit that they post up on this thing, man? It's almost like, for them, it's like a safe haven. They feel like they can't communicate with no one else in the world. So they go on there and it's just like a forum to express themselves. Bunch of bitches, some of them people, man.